Good evening, everyone. Good evening. A lovely Monday evening to all of you. Hope you had a good weekend, and also hope that work has been good so far. It's 5 p.m. here. I'm sure most of us are winding down, getting ready to go home, or some of us are on the way to the house. So you can just come on live with me and just let's talk a bit about leadership. It's very important. Africa, especially Africa. Daniel, log in, please. Check the chat for me. Anyone I need to know. All right. So Africa, we're in dire need of leaders, especially business leaders, politicians. We need to understand leadership. It's very key and very important for us that we understand leadership. So in this leadership series, I want to get deep into certain things I feel that we should know. Every week I will take the tempo higher, because Africa, we need leadership. We have a problem with leadership in almost all the areas of life. We need leadership, even at home, even as parents, husbands, wives. We need leadership. So it's when I take this leadership courses, I take them very, very seriously because we need to raise leaders. And though I'll be talking more from the part of the workplace and the business person, but really it should cut across any all spheres of life, where as long as there are people, then there's leadership. As long as you have people, then you have leadership. So today we're dealing with, why is communication very, very important? Why is it so important in leadership? Communication and leadership, they go hand in hand. So I welcome you this evening to the Marketplace with Uche Onoche, and thank you for joining. Those of you on Facebook and those of you on Instagram, like I always say, if you want to move over to Zoom, there's more than enough room for you on Zoom. You should move over to Zoom, because I feel that then you can see my presentation that I'm using to do this. And there's something about seeing presentation and seeing write-ups, and it can help you understand more. And maybe if you want to write, you can write one or two things. So I will advise, if you want to move to Zoom, you can. The link is in the advert that we put out in all of our handles. Okay, so let me go straight ahead and start. Why is communication very important in leadership? Why is it very important in leadership? It's not just only important, it's very critical, extremely critical in running any form of organization. Communication is a core leadership function and a key characteristic of every good leader. Because how can you lead? How can you be in front when you don't know how to encourage people, when you don't know how to carry people along? And there's no way we will know what is on the inside of you if you don't tell us. There's no way we can understand your vision if you're not able to clearly articulate it. So it is critical, it is crucial that a leader should be able to communicate. Effective communication and effective leadership, they are closely intertwined. Leaders need to be skilled communicators in countless relationships, like organizational level, like communities, like groups, and sometimes on a global scale. It does not matter where you find yourself, which nation you find yourself, or which area of this sector of society you find yourself. As a leader, you should be able to lead. And some qualities, you need to have some certain qualities that will make you a better leader. And that's some of the reason why we have this presentation. A leader thinks with clarity. He expresses ideas and shares information with multitude of audiences. So a leader must be able to learn to handle the rapid flow of information that is coming. Now that we're in the formation jet age, a leader should be able to handle the rapid flow of information within the organization among customers, partners, stakeholders, shareholders, and all the investors out there that affect the organization of business. So sharing information is very key. Sharing information is very important. And to whom you share this information? Look at the ND of a company. If you have a board, you must be able to be report effectively to the board. They are not running the organization on a day-to-day basis with you, but you should be able to interpret and pass on information to them. Likewise, you should be able to also marshal your army, which are usually the management team, and the management team should be able to carry the rest of their subordinates along, and it has to flow in that order. Leadership has to flow in that order, that everybody is communicating, everybody is talking. Because if you're not talking, there is no way people will know what is happening within the organization. There's no way people will know. So we need to continue to talk. We need to know how to talk to our partners, our stakeholders, our shareholders, our influencers, and anybody that is contributing or associated with your organization or your business. So let us see some facts about communication for leaders. Facts about communication for leaders. One, authenticity is very key. Authenticity is very key. Authenticity is very, in fact, they say authenticity is magnetic. It is magnetic, and it counts a lot in what a business a leader does. It counts a lot in what a leader does. So to be authentic is to be honest and to be sincere. To be honest and to be sincere about situations what are happening, the situations that are happening in organizations. I sometimes marvel when leaders and business owners are trying to cover up the true image of what is happening, or the true picture of what is happening in their organization, you know, or in their company. Every leader must be authentic. You must find your own voice. You must be able to find your own voice. More like be comfortable in your own skin. Because if you're not comfortable with your own skin, not only are people judging you, you also are judging yourself. Every time you make a speech, you will ask yourself, did I say the right thing? Did I, you know, you see some certain leaders. And yeah, you should get feedback from those that are very close to you from time to time. Every leader should get a feedback, but not the one that you're requesting feedback because you're not sure of what you have done or what you have said. A leader should be able to be comfortable in their own skin. A leader should even be comfortable in their own decisions. You should be very comfortable with your own decision, even when you fail. All of us fail. After all, failure is the ladder that leads us to success, because without failing, you will not be able to understand, you will not be able to attain success. So you should be able to be comfortable, find your own voice. Quit talking in corporate speak, what they call corporate speak, corporate jargons, corporate lingos, and all that you use to confuse people. Sounding like someone you are not. I remember one of my sons came back recently, and he was talking. He was talking in a certain way, and I said, talking to his brothers, and he was talking in a certain way, and I was like, why are you talking like that? He said, well, that is the way my principal talks. I started laughing. I know this principal, and that's not the way he talks normally. So I said, where? He said, no, that this is in the assembly. That's how he talks. And I started laughing because you don't need to change your voice. You don't need to speak in a better way. And you don't need to press your nose so that you can speak in a certain way, in a certain manner. And people will take and feel that if you speak plenty big grammars and you say a lot of big things that people generally okay, someone is saying that I should mute other people. Let me just do that now. Please when you come on and just mute yourself. Okay. Okay, I think I've done that. So I was talking about not be, try as much as possible not to to be yourself, to be comfortable. You don't need, you don't need to carry on, speak and appear differently for you to be authentic. Being authentic is being original. It's you, it's being original. You are just being an original. You don't need to be something else. You don't need to be something more than what you are. So let who you are, where you come from, and what you value come true in your communication. Let what you value come true in your communication. See, the more you talk to people, the more they get to know who you are, the more they get to understand the vision. Don't be afraid of being vulnerable even before your people. Don't be afraid to call your colleague, even if you are paying them salary, and ask for advice. Don't be afraid to tell your colleague or tell your staff and say, look, you have strength in this area more than me, so do this or handle this aspect. It doesn't take anything from you. It doesn't take away from you being a CEO. It does not. Being authentic is being real. People want to respect and follow an authentic leader. So forget about being eloquent, just like my son's principal. He was trying to be eloquent and show us he went to Oxford. It doesn't take that for you to be a good leader. Worry about being real. Don't worry about what people say. When I started speaking, I didn't like my voice. I used to say my voice is not good enough. Maybe I should go for voice training. Maybe I need to speak. When you start something, there's always some part of your body that you don't like. Maybe you like to be taller. Maybe you like to be fair skinned. Maybe you like to be darker. There's always something that we don't want. And we look at those things more and forget that we have so much quality. Qualities within us that we should look into. Don't worry about being eloquent. Don't worry about being passive in a certain way. Worry about being yourself. Worry about let people see you for who you are. Because really what you are is what you are made of is all that you can give to us. But let me tell you something. All that you can give to us is what makes you unique and what attracts you to us. So be unique by just being yourself. Leaders are just be yourself. Being yourself is what makes you unique, is what makes you different from others. But when you're trying to be something you are not, because nobody can pretend and act 24 hours of the day, even the actors that are well paid, what you see on television is not their real, that is not their real life. That one is make-believe. But as a leader, you don't need to make believe anything. We don't need make believe. We want you to be who you are. And you see, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid at all. Don't be afraid in any way. Don't be afraid at all. Don't be afraid at all, Banji. Don't be afraid at all of being who you are. People will never willingly follow anyone they feel is inauthentic. Nobody wants to follow a fake person. Just like they say, the guy is fake. The guy is fake. Why would somebody want to follow someone they seem as being fake? Being fake is being seen as being inauthentic. So be yourself. Be yourself. Leaders are themselves. They are themselves. Be yourself. Okay. Another fact about leadership is visibility. You must be visible. Visibility is a form of communication. Look at the, if you can see my slide, you can see the leader, the one that is red, is there, is visible among the people. If you want to communicate well, don't be out of sight. Don't be out of sight. You know, I argued this with a friend of mine. I argued for 2 hours why he doesn't come to work. And when he comes to work, he doesn't see anybody. He has a back entrance. He comes in through the back. He leaves through the back. That sometimes his staff do not even know when he comes in and when he leaves. He say, look, he has to be scarce. You know, it's good to be scarce sometimes so that they don't see you. When they see you, they work better. When they see you, they more like worship you. They more like respect you more. I say, well, they might be afraid of you. They don't see you much. But not being around is not good for business. Don't be known only by emails and official missives. That is official long letters. Letters and all those things that you send, you know, I've worked in a place that nobody talks to you much, but they just be sending emails. It's not personal. It's not personal. A leader, in as much as you work with emails, so that there will be records that things were done, that messages were transferred to you, that instructions were transferred to you, that there's record that we can refer to, and something tangible that we can refer to, you know. But apart from that, you have to be present. You have to be visible. You have to be available. Sometimes get out of your office and walk around the office. Speak to people. If somebody is frowning, ask them what is wrong with them today. Somebody is not feeling well and comes to work. You can see that he's struggling. Ask them, why are you, is everything okay? Why don't you take the day off, go home and get some rest? You are in tune with them. You are not far. Get out there consistently and predictably. Let others know what kind of leader you are. We know that you are the boss. We know that you own everything. But we also want to know your heart. People want to know the heart of their leader. People will do the job. I have seen in certain places I have served, and people come to me and say, look, sir, we are doing this job because of you, not because of this organization. Many times I've been told that we are doing this, even in church. The departments have run, have come, and people tell me, look, we are doing this job because of you, because of the way you carry us along. Not necessarily because we have to, after all, is a voluntary work. We can serve in church or we choose not to serve, and God will still bless us and God will still love us. So it takes you being out there in the life of your people. And this is some of the things I used to enjoy doing. I go around and I speak to them, you know, and sometimes it's just they're having issues at home. And sometimes you see that people are having issues at home, and that is what is affecting their productivity. What is happening? I saw a man, a married man of many years, drinking Coca-Cola and bread without any, with not, there was no jam, there was no butter, margarine, nothing. He was just eating. And I said, what kind of thing is it? How can you be eating this? You have been married, and he now, that opened up a discussion about his marital, some of the challenges he was having at home. So I was able to help him and guide him, and I brought peace to the home. And the guy became more productive. He became a happier person. So it goes beyond just the job and the work itself. It goes beyond that. You have to be out there and let people know that you are a boss that cares. Nobody cares that you have so much money. There's so much billionaires all over the place. So it's not as if it's not nothing new that one person after a while or from time to time, somebody just breaks out of the mold and becomes a billionaire. We see it all the time. We see 20-something year old billionaires. So it's not that new. It's not that new. Nobody cares how much you have, but everybody cares how much you care. Everybody cares about your heart. And that is the most important thing, because people can forget that you paid them. People can forget that you paid their school fees. People can forget all the good things you have done for them, but they will not forget. People can forget all the monies you paid for them, but they will not forget the conversation you had with them at their lowest point. They will not forget you. People need to see you, feel who you are, and feel connected to the work that you want them to do. They need to feel you. They need to understand you. These are the things that make them willingly say, okay, we put in our best in this job, in this organization. Haven't you seen that most people, even in stock exchange, in the capital market, people invest in the MD and the leaders of organization? Like me, if I want to invest in a stock, I want to understand two things first. Who is running? Who are the people that are running this organization? And are they credible people? I'm not going to invest in stock of a company that is doing well when the owners have shady character. I wouldn't do that. And at the same time, I want to know, are they manufacturing something? Or they are just building castles in the sky and trying to collect people's money? People want to feel you. Find ways to interact with all your stakeholders. Even to your driver is your stakeholder. Because he can drive you into a ditch, can drive into a ravine. It can end your life. So you must be visible. You must be. I know of one MD of which I said, well, I have something I need to, I will imbibe at some point in my life. So I tried to do it as I used to do it, but I said I was going to start doing it more. This guy is a multi-billionaire, a global investor and business person. But he makes out time, if he's in the country, his driver is doing birthday, baby dedication, or whatever. He comes in for like 10, 20, 15 minutes. If anybody, any of his staff, even those that don't know him, haven't seen him, he visits them. If it's within, he can do it within the space of time he has, he will do it for, he will come and visit you. So you can imagine the lowest of the people in the lowest cadre. Can't imagine why this man, they only see on television or his picture hanging somewhere in the office, is coming to their own house, even those that live in shanties. So you can imagine what perception do you think of that person is going to have of that leader. The guy is ready to take a bullet for you after that time. He will be your ambassador. This visibility is very, very key and very, very important because it communicates a lot about who you are. And who you are, our perception of who you are, is what helps us to do the work better. Okay, so let us go to... No. All right. Another fact about communication is listening is a powerful skill. Listening is a powerful skill. Good communicators are also good listeners. You cannot communicate without listening. I know a lot of people like to hear themselves, especially those that feel that they have a gift of the gab, or those that feel that they have become seasoned coaches. Being a coach, the first tool of being a coach is to be able to listen and to listen effectively. You cannot coach without hearing. Who are you coaching when you cannot hear what they are saying? Who are you coaching if you cannot hear? So you need to be able to listen carefully. When you listen well, you gain what? A clear understanding of another person's perspective that is different from yours. You get a clearer perspective on what is even going on. There are two sides of a story. It takes a good listener to be able to deduce which one is the truth out of it, or what is close to the truth out of it. But most importantly, you gain knowledge from it. That's why we started Wednesday Live by 4 p.m. every Wednesday. Because we also want to hear from people hear from them their issues and be able to answer them directly. There's no need to talk to people. You are not getting a feedback from them. Yes, one of your staff, they failed in the assignment that you give to them, even if you're upset, but listen to them first. Perhaps you will learn something that can help them be better. Listen first before you kill anybody. Listen first before you start foaming in the mouth with anger. Listen first to understand what the issues are. Listening does what? It fosters trust, respect, and openness. When you listen to somebody, even if you're not, if you're upset with them, give time and listen to them, they will respect you for giving them that listening ear. Even if you're going to scold them afterwards and be open, but you listen to them and listen to their challenge and you advise them based on that. Active listening is key to coaching others. Active listening is a key part of coaching others. Without listening, you cannot coach. So allow people to air their grievances and complaints. You know, don't allow people to say, no, we don't quarrel in this office. We don't fight in this office. No matter, don't do that here. Don't bring it here. This is an office space. But as long as there are two or three people gathered, there must be offenses. And don't overlook offenses, because somebody that is grieved inside, it will affect his output. There must be a way, even if it's subtle, for people to make their complaints and you listen to them. Because you might be saying sales is down. People are aggrieved because the sales manager perhaps doesn't know how to talk or doesn't know how to lead. But maybe the sales manager is related to your wife, so you won't even want to hear anything. You need to allow and listen to people objectively and deduce the one that you will know, the ones that are jokers, the ones that are serious. But every man that has a legitimate grievance should be listened to. And as the leader there, you are the judge. So you need to be fair to all concerned. And for you to be fair, you need to listen to them. Ask questions that open the door to what people really think and feel. Ask questions that will open the door to what people really think and feel. And now pay close and respectful attention to what is said and what's left unsaid. Because there's always things that are left unsaid. I have to train myself to listen to what people are not saying and encourage them when I'm talking to them and bringing out what I think they are not saying. And most times you see them begin to respond in line with what they are not saying, because nobody says all at once. What they say most of the time is not all they mean. So when you listen, you'll be able to understand, oh, I think that this guy is coming from this angle or coming from here. But listen first. When you listen, you will get, information about what is actually happening. Okay, so let's look at tips now. Tips for leaders to communicate more effectively. Okay, so let's look at some tips. Communication is one. Communicate relentlessly. You have to communicate relentlessly. I can't remember who said this, but I think it's one communication course I took. And the speaker kept on saying, or maybe I listened to it in one of YouTube many, many years ago. He said, when people begin to say that you sound like a broken record, that is when they are actually hearing you. That don't expect that people will hear you the first time. No. Don't expect that people, somebody comes to work and you say, this is the company culture, this is the rules and regulation in the company, this is how we, it does not, yes, he heard you, but hearing and that which they've heard being impressed into their heart and their mind, is they are two different things. You have to communicate relentlessly. Before people begin to get the vision, nobody gets the vision at once. You are in a meeting and you share the vision. In some meetings, they will say, okay, let everybody read the vision out loud. But you, as the vision bearer, you have to continue to share the vision. You have to continue to share the vision until they tell you you are sounding like a broken record. That is when you can say that they are hearing you. Communicate relentlessly. Never give up. It takes, and you see, the vision is understood in phases and in stages. So maybe they just understood the phase one of the vision. Try not to unbundle all the vision at once. Unbundle the vision one after the other, different levels, so that people can get it. But what I'm saying is that you need to communicate relentlessly. Communicate information, thoughts, and ideas clearly and frequently through different media. Keep processes open and transparent. And find ways to help smooth the path of communication for your team or organization. Find ways to help them understand more. Shed all traces of detachment and arrogance. And take the time to talk to your people. Don't be detached from the people you are supposed to be leading. Don't be detached. Don't be arrogant because you have the position or God has blessed you for you to be able to start a company. Because then you are not, they will not. Every trace of arrogance, it's not as if arrogance doesn't mean being firm. You can be firm, doesn't mean that you're arrogant. But you being firm is that as a leader, you must be firm to the rules and regulations. And most of the time, rules and regulations are not fixed by you alone. They are fixed by a team. Rules and regulations are fixed by a team. So it's everybody that came together and said, this is the disciplinary measures we're going to take for lateness, for this, for that. So communicate relentlessly. Do not be tired. Always talk. Always share the vision. Always make the big picture clearer. Make the big picture seen. For me, when I'm talking to people, I want to leave a picture in your mind. I use a lot of examples. I use a lot of stories. Why? Because I want you to remember the story. Because for me, I think in pictures and images. So because I think in pictures and images, so when I don't remember what you said, I remember the story or the image that I had in my mind at that time. It helps me to recall what was said easily. And this was what I used in my school. This is what I used as a speaker. So find ways that can help you communicate to your team, tell them, and be able to speak to them consistently. Okay, so another tip is be simple, be direct. No UN speech, please. No political speech. No, don't show us how much. Just be simple and be direct. Say what you mean and mean what you say. Be simple and direct. Be direct and go straight to the point. Don't waste too much time in trying. Go straight to the point. People will respect you for that. Don't hide behind complexities or pile on tons of information. Tons of information. You know, some people like to bring too much information to know, to show that they are knowledgeable, and they hide under complexities. Don't be that kind of a leader. Simple communication can be what is called smart communication. No ambiguities. Let it be clear. Let it be simple. Let's get straight to forward and do and get to the bottom of what the problem is as fast as possible, because time is precious to us, to everybody. Simple communication can be smart communication. Another is always listen first. We've talked about listening, but let us look at it from another angle. Listen to encourage. Listen and encourage input. Listen and draw them in. You have to be able to listen to be able to draw people in and draw them into conversations. Because there's a lot of hidden talents in extroverts. You need to be able to draw them in. So learn to pause and to be okay with silence sometimes. Encourage the other people to offer ideas. You know it. But allow your staff and other people to offer ideas, because give them chance to grow. You know where you're going. As the leader, you know where you're going. But those meetings are also places where you train people. Allow them to talk. You know where the conversation is going to end. You already have an idea where the conversation is going to end. But speak with them. Let them bring out their ideas. That is also when you will know those that have leadership qualities. It's during those meetings that you get to know those that have leadership qualities. You get to know the stuff that are within your people. So listen, be silent. Learn to be silent. Listen and get and learn from other people. If you're not silent, you'll not be able to learn from other people. And guess what? The younger generation knows something more about tech more than the older generation. So you also learn something from your people. And don't think that you're the boss that can only, you're the one that is only dishing out knowledge. You're the one that has all the information. They have information too. Do 80% listening and 20% of the talking. Showing interest in and respect for your colleagues will help you make the emotional connection. And this is the emotional connection that connects you to people, that makes people do things for you rather than doing it even for the organization. This is one of the key areas of effective leadership, being able to connect with someone emotionally. Let your team members know they are valuable, show empathy, create psychological safety for them. When they come to talk to you about certain things, advise them and don't take their secret and say it during the meeting. Don't take what they said to you and broadcast it during the meeting. Don't use what they said to advise somebody else. Let there be a safety net, a psychological safety net for them in you. Show empathy for others. It will show those that you lead that you care for both them and the organization. The watchword here is care. They need to understand that you care for them. And once you can show them that you care for them, it becomes easy for them to follow you. It becomes easy that even when the job, the task is very difficult, they will follow you because they know that you're a leader that cares. Not just for the job or for the organization or just for the money that is being made, but because, no, you truly care. Everybody will follow a leader that shows empathy. Okay. Another tip is to illustrate true stories. I've said a bit, but it's important. You see that every organization, they come up with the origin. In the website of organizations, even in companies, people want to know the origin. Origin. You will see it in company, what do they profile? The origin. The origin. The origin. Where did this all start? Learn to tell good stories. Give life to a vision, your goal, and objective by telling stories. I like to tell stories. I like to give inferences because this is what helps me pass the true meaning of the vision and the foundation that I'm running by telling stories. Tell them the origin. Tell them the difficult areas you went through and how God helped you to overcome it. How you were able to overcome it. What are the things that happened to you? People, that is what people want to know. People want to know your story. Don't come and say, praise the Lord, God did it for us, without telling us the story and the things that you went through. The younger generation want to know what you went through to become who you are today. Tell them stories. Those stories validate your vision. They give life to your vision, your goal, and your objective. Telling good stories creates trust. People will trust because they now know they can see what you went through. It captures hearts and minds. It endears people to you. Oh, this man is committed to this vision. Maybe we can help him and support him. This man is committed to this vision. It serves as a reminder of the vision. The stories, people are captivated by the stories of how it was, how the miraculous journey to where you are. It helps the vision. Tell stories. It helps people come alongside you. People find it easier to respect a story or refer to an image or a quote than talk about vision statement. You come and read vision statement for somebody, strategic document and project plans that we need to make. They can be boring. Some of us sit there because we just have to sit there because we are being paid for it. But when you tell stories, all these documents become easier to handle. They become easier to handle. So tell stories. Tell stories. It helps you to be an effective leader. Tell story. Have you wondered why if you go and meet the elderly, go to the villages and meet your grandfather and great, what do you go there for? Stories. When you go to meet a mentor, what do you go there for? Stories. Have you seen great speakers? The more, even great preachers and pastors and religious leaders, the more they get older, they don't preach the Bible anymore. They just tell you stories and you are blessed. They just tell stories because their life is a testimony in itself. Stories help the vision, and it helps you to communicate more effectively. Affirmation through actions is another tip. Affirm with your actions. Affirm your people with your actions. Effective leaders master the art and craft of language. Affirm, speak clearly, and present logical and compelling arguments. Skilled leaders also know that communication goes beyond words. So you not affirm only with words, but also with your actions. Actions are very important. If people hear one thing from you and see another thing, see you doing another thing, you lose credibility in their sight. And they'll tell you, preacher, don't preach what you cannot act. Don't preach that thing that you cannot do to us. What you say should be what you do as a leader. Practice what you preach. Yeah, that's the word. Practice what you preach. We can't hear you keep saying one thing and you're leading a different life. People need to trust you. Your behavior and your actions communicate a world of information. So be clear on the messages you send when you are not saying anything. Be careful of the messages, your body language, how you affirm people, how you speak to them is very important. Your actions affirm that you can imagine someone failed an assignment and you come out and you tell the person, I know that you failed. Let this not be a habit, but I trust, I know that you have something on the inside of you. I know you will do well the next time, even if you don't believe it. Sometimes you need to say some things, even if you don't believe it, because it brings out the best in people. Tell your staff that failed. Don't make it a habit, but I know you will do better because I employed you because I saw something inside of you. That person will do better next time. You have offended him. He knows that you should have tongue-lashed him or you should have punished him in one way or the other. But instead of punishing him, you offended him. That can bring out the best in people. Affirm with your actions. And you have a strong followership afterwards. Leaders communicate with actions and attitude. 2, let me explain that. Leaders communicate with actions and attitude too. Let's see what it means. At a very basic level, communication is the transmission of meaning between sender and receiver. Communication is what? The transmission of meaning, of content, of a message between the sender and the receiver. But realize that your attitude and actions also give additional meaning to your spoken and written messages. Your actions go a long way to either affirm what you have said, to either encourage what you have said, or to make people say that he's saying one thing and his body language is saying another thing. Your behavior gives people information about your disposition, your opinion, and your mood, regardless of the words that you speak. So your actions must be in sync with your words. If you care, even when you're angry, it must show that you care. Your words and your actions must be. So a leader must watch what he says. A leader must learn to be calm and not be moved by anger. But I know we are human beings. It's better you are angry and be silent. You are angry and walk away and be silent than say things that will make your team begin to see you in a different light. I'm not saying you cannot affirm and you cannot discipline. But you discipline not from the point of anger, not when you're angry. You discipline because it's needful to keep some form of order and sanity in the organization. But discipline is not the only way. It's not the only option. It's not the first option. what you say, your behavior gives people information about who you are, your disposition, opinion, and your moods, regardless of what you say. Communication can disclose the leader's authenticity, the leader's sincerity, and virtually every aspect of the leader by the way he communicates. When a leader is all talk and no substance, people see right through that leader. When it's all talk and no substance, after a while, they will see it. And people will say, do I want to follow this kind of leader? So your actions, everybody wants to look up to a man of integrity. Everybody wants to look up to a man that say, this is what you get and this is what you get. You know, I know someone, I met somebody, I thought that this man was a decent man until I heard him say something. He always have staff coming and going, coming and going, coming. Today he has 20 staff, tomorrow he has 15, next tomorrow he has 25 staff. What is happening? And I asked him, and he said, I don't mind these people that they will come here and tell you, I want to earn 100,000, I want to earn 200,000. It's okay now. You will earn it. But he will owe you for 6 months. In the seventh month, he will pay you one. Huh? In the seventh month, he will pay you one. Pay you for 1 month. You continue for another 5 months. You pay. There was a popular, I don't want to call his name, there was a popular oil and gas person. In Port Harcourt, did it to all his staff, and he had over thousands of his staff that they now begin to beg to be paid. When they pay one salary in 8 months, everybody will jubilate. He has conditioned them. That was classical conditioning. And some people do it. They do it. They will pay you 200,000. It's okay. After 6 months, they will pay you. They will keep paying you. They will owe you. And until you get tired and leave, then you write a lawyer. They will write their own lawyer. It becomes a case, or you keep coming. After another 4 months, they will pay you one until you get tired and leave them and place curses on them and walk away. But that is his own leadership style. And after a while, people inside began to see him for who he is, and equipment started missing. They started doing their own business within the business, and before you know it, everything crumbled. So talk the talk and walk the walk. Put your money where your mouth is. So a leader communication style says a lot about his character, his or her character. A leader's communication style. You must have, that's why I say be yourself. Be yourself. And when you are yourself, you can accommodate anything. You don't have any airs of, I'm the boss, I have to be like this. Just be yourself. If you're a kind boss, be a kind boss. If you're not so much of a kind boss, be who you are. Just be fair to all concerned. Be fair to all concerned. And be fair to your fellow man. You don't have to even be nice to do. Give to them what is due them. And that's it. And be nice to people and talk. You don't have to go overboard. I'm not telling you to go overboard here. No. But there's something about being there for another human being, especially if you are the boss, to help them. They never forget it. That's how to build strong and effective teams that will, they are ready to die for you and take a bullet for you. And strong teams, they do what? They become strong organizations and strong companies. Okay, what effective leaders do when they communicate? Let's look at what do they do when they communicate. They handle resistant audiences well. You know, at the beginning I told you one of the means that we will know that you are an effective leader, you must be versatile in talking to different audiences. To stakeholders, you must be able to know how to talk to your shareholders before they vote you out and you have no job. You must be able to know how to talk to your suppliers before they cut off supply. You must be able to let them know that the company is struggling. We might not be able, we used to pay you every 90 days, but we're extending it to 120 days because of Corona, because of the global pandemic. You should be able to know how to talk to them, carry them along. You should be able to know how to talk to a staff that is saying, I have been here. I need certain privileges. I need something or the other. You should be able to know how to carry your staff along. You should be able to know how to carry every stakeholder, the influencers. You should be able to know how to carry your community, your influencers, your social media community. You should be able to know how to talk to them. You should be able to know how to communicate. It's very important because a leader is doing what? Communicating in words and in action. In words and in action, a leader is ever communicating. Okay? So what effective leaders do when they communicate is that they listen to individuals from all levels, at all levels of the organization. They listen. They encourage direct and open discussions. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to open discussions. I've seen from experience that, you know, we always have, every organization always have one staff. You know, every big organization, let me see big organization, because small organizations might not have it. Big organization, you always have somebody that wants to oppose whatever what other people are saying. Not because he doesn't believe in what they are saying, but he just wants to be different. Some people are difficult. Some people just waste time in talking. Some people don't have what to say, but they want to say something. Some people are harsh, aggressive in the things. You know, and I've seen a CEO that, I won't have that meeting because these people from this department that they just come here, they are full of trouble. No, but a leader should be able to face everybody, have an open discussion and be able to moderate. You are the moderator. You'll be able to know when to, okay, I will set up a committee to look into this. We need to move on to the next item on the agenda. You are the one. You are the driver. You are the one. You are the puppet master. You are the one that is, you are the producer and director of that movie. Don't be afraid to confront difficult people. Don't be afraid. Also, what they do is that they initiate difficult but needed and necessary conversations. An effective leader is one that will bring out that elephant in the room, that topic that nobody wants to talk about. That thing in the organization that everybody is saying, no, I don't want to be part of this. I don't want to be part of that. I don't want to. Everybody knows that this should be solved, but nobody is willing to talk about it. An effective leader is someone that knows how to use wisdom to bring out difficult to initiate difficult, very difficult situations, and we'll be able to talk about it. We'll be able to talk about it. No matter what. I've had to handle a case of two men in an organization. Even the things that we were fighting, we thought that it was job related. We did not know that it was not job related. It was social. It was something that happened to them in their own social setting, but it's affecting them. And their two managers, it was affecting the world. At some point, it had to be brought up, and they said all manner of things about each other. But at the end of the day, it was peace, and boundaries were set, and new policies were set because we ventured to confront difficult issues. When you confront difficult issues, it gives you opportunity to set up policies that will counter those things and make sure they don't come again. Okay, effective leaders are clear about expectations and ask good questions. They are clear about expectations. They are not expecting you to bring the moon, but they are clear on that expectation. What is expected of the company this year in terms of target? in terms of what we want to do, what is expected, and the effective leaders ask good questions. You can train yourself to ask good questions. There are courses. There are a lot of courses, free courses on the internet that will teach you how to ask, good questions. Because when you ask good questions, you get good responses. And those good responses are the things that make organizations. They're the things that make organizations to be good. And from being good, they become great. Because don't think about making your organization good. Being good is not good enough. It has to be great. You have to be great. So be clear, ask good questions. Learn. You can learn it on the internet, on YouTube, how to write, ask good questions, and bring out the best responses from people. Involve others before developing a plan of action. Very important. Leaders involve others before they develop a plan of action, especially when they are the ones that are going to execute it. They are the ones that have been executing it for a long while. So what you need to do is need to ask their opinion. Not that they determine everything, but please, in the multitude of counselors, there's safety. So get all the information that you want from everybody, and this is what is going to help you to become an effective leader. Okay, so in summary, I say this, for better relationship, for better leadership communication, think not only about words, but also your attitude and your actions. They go hand in hand. Your actions are actually as important as the words. They are actually as important as the words that you say to someone. So you cannot be encouraging with your mouth, but your body language is saying, I don't have energy for this. Let me just encourage him, let him go. Your actions must be in line or in sync with the words that you're saying. It will make a huge difference to your people and to your organization. Guys, Africa is in dire need of leaders. And this foundation was started on leadership and business. It was a core, and still part of the arm of our foundation is on leadership. Like I said to us, I've done business from last year, teachings on business and enterprise from last year to, I think it was in February, we started leadership. I'm going to do leadership for two months because Africa is in dire need of leadership. And I'm each step, each week, I'm bringing a different angle of leadership. Practical things, deep practical things that leaders need to know and leaders need to do. So these next 2 months are going to be very critical to what we do, to those that we are offering this service to. It is free, and this is our CSL to you out there. And please, Africa is in dire need of leaders. So I'm passionate about these leadership trainings. If you know someone in leadership, please, next Monday, don't leave them out. As you receive the advert, the promo for next Monday, forward it to them. Remind them on Sunday night, remind them on Monday afternoon that they need to come for this leadership training. Because the core of the things we do here is business, leadership, career development, personal finance, marriages, relationship, both corporate and personal. These are some of the things that we do in this place. So if you have someone that, if you know someone, please bring them in. I have some of the topics that I will be doing, teaching here is how to find your own voice. How to find your voice as a leader. How to stop trying to be like somebody else. How do I find my voice? That's one. We will also learn how to communicate during crisis. How do I communicate as a leader is very important. You know, we're also going to learn there are many of such topics. We're also going to learn how talent management and organizational effectiveness. You know, so these are some of the topics. These are some of the topics that we will be looking at. Very, very, very important. Okay, so and as we do this, I have a group of mentees where if I teach, there's more information. These mentees can ask me any question at any time. This is what I've committed myself to. So if you want to be part of that group of people that I mentor to greatness, these are people that can ask me, you said this thing, sir. What do you mean? And I will take my time, call them, reach out to them, and speak to them. If you want to have that opportunity, then you can sign up for my mentorship class or mentorship community, not a class. It doesn't run as a class. It runs based on request and need, what people need, and I offer it to them. And it's linktree.com/uchionoche, but it's spelled like this, linktr.ee/uchionoche. linktr.ee/uchionoche. There, you can ask me direct questions. Yeah, you can ask me direct questions and I will call you and I will speak to you. A lot of people ask questions and I speak to them directly. I give challenges, affirmations, and things that can encourage people in based on the things that we're dealing with. So now is a time for leadership. We will be participating a lot. I'll be bringing out things and challenges that can help us participate and learn this leadership aspect from the WhatsApp community. So please, if you know someone, forward that link to them. Also, invite someone next week, Monday. If you have a question, you can also ask me, put it on the DM for next on Wednesday by 4 p.m. I come and I answer. There is no script. On Wednesday, there is no script. I just answer based on what you ask me. So whatever question that you didn't, and I don't know you, all the people that ask me questions on marriages and all, I don't know you. And I don't get to know you afterwards. So I just answer you in truth. I answer you to the best of my ability that this is what I think. And a lot of people are being blessed. I still don't know them. They just tell me, thank you, you saved the life. But I don't know them. They are not even in my city. Some are not even in my country. And they ask questions and they are being blessed. So please avail yourself of this opportunity and let all of us grow together. As you're growing, I am also growing by the things I am learning. And also I have the privilege of being able to impact on you. And as I'm impacting on you, I am also impacting on myself. So it is all of us are working together in this to become better people. So as I leave you now this evening, see you on Wednesday by 4 p.m. Also see you on Monday next week by 5 p.m. I come with another interesting topic to you. So until then, have a good night, rest, and get home safely, and God bless. Thank you very much.